Right, I'm ready for a take. Oh, you prefer close up? Is that better? I mean, it's a bit close. And you'll put the effects on afterwards. Okay. Let's go. How was that? Good. You'll definitely put the ears in afterwards. But you'll still be able to see my face, right? Welcome to vlog 28. Did we all see the Cats trailer? Wow. I mean, I don't really know what I was expecting, but... It wasn't that. I mean, what? I have no words. Yeah. You know what? I'm gonna reserve judgment. Let's just wait till Christmas and see how bad it is. I mean, I know a few people who worked on it. And I don't even think they were prepared for that trailer. But yeah. Interesting. I worked with Tom Hooper on Les Mis, and he's a bit bonkers, to be honest. So, yeah, I don't know why I'm surprised. This week's been all about cabarets. I didn't see any other theatre. I feel like I almost moved into Zadel. I was there every night. But I'm okay with that. Although, if I hear one more version of Shallow, I might actually go gaga. Oh, please, if you thought that joke was bad, you should have seen some of Alex Lodge's. Speaking of which, Alex kicked off the week with his own cabaret, Pints, Pals and Diabetes, at the Sing Easy Space at Piano Works West End. I'll be honest, I quite fancy him. Well, a lot. Well, yeah, I really fancy him. The whole evening was in aid of Diabetes UK and Acting for Others. Basically because Alex is an actor with diabetes, so all the money he raised will come straight back to him. That was his joke. I stole it. You know what? Alex is adorable. In fact, he's quite fit, if I'm allowed to say that. But I had no idea that he was a manic depressive and struggles with anxiety. It's remarkable. During the evening, he talked openly about his disorders in a very frank and open and honest way, which completely surprised me. I never saw Alex when he was in Book of Mormon, but I recently saw him in a production of Romance Romance at Above the Stag, and he is incredible. And like I say, he's pretty damn fit. And yet, in spite of this, it just goes to show, you really don't know what's going on beneath the surface. Alex made a very empowering speech where he talked about his diabetes and about his mental health, saying that he never uses the term suffering because he doesn't want to be a victim. He also talked about how his diabetes had recently prevented him from accepting a job, which is a real eye-opener. He presented two shows with an array of guests, including Matthew Hartley from Jesus Christ Superstar, Lucy May Barker from Mamma Mia, Molly Melia Redgrave, and also Grace Myatt. I think that's how you say her name. On the piano was Alex's best friend, Chris Rawlinson. It was a really fantastic evening, and Alex is so, so funny. Honestly. Why he's single, just saying. He wasn't straight. He probably wouldn't fancy me anyway. And also in the audience was Ollie Dobson, who went to Arts Ed with Alex. He is about to start rehearsals for Back to the Future, which I cannot wait for. Here are a few clips from the evening.
On the outside, always looking in, will it ever be more than I've always been? Cause I'm tired, tired, tapping on the glass. I'm waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear. On watch, watch, watch your people pass. I'm waving through a window.
For the first time in forever, there'll be music, there'll be light. For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through.
Obsession with Alex, you can find him in the lineup for a Crazy Cox Presents Musicals of the 90s on Sunday the 28th of January. July. On Sunday the 28th of July, where he will be joined by Emma Kingston, Rebecca Locke, Courtney Reed, and James Hume. So on Tuesday, I was at the Crazy Cox to start my marathon week watching the Big Smoke London Festival. And I started the week by interviewing Amy Bartolomeo. I think that's how you say her name. Now, unfortunately, Amy's was one of the cabarets that I didn't get to see because I was too busy filming. But I did manage to catch up with her on Tuesday afternoon and have a little chat all about her career and about her show. And she did tell me off camera that she will be starting the UK tour of We Will Rock You, playing the part of Ozzy, or Oz. It used to be called Brit, but now it's been changed. Anyway, I cannot wait to see her when she starts in September in Bromley. And was so excited. She is adorable. Here's a little clip from the interview, which you can find on my YouTube page. If you had to pick one of your favourite places that you visited.
New Zealand.
Was it?
Oh my God. We were just in the daytime, going to a waterfall, and then going to sound check. And just going to warm up, just doing your pin curls. Where have you been today? Oh, just waterfall.
Don't get that in West End, do you? So on Tuesday night, I watched Emma Lindes in her cabaret As We Grow Older, which is a title song from her debut album. She was joined by musical director Tom Knowles, who also worked on her album. Emma is incredible. Her voice is insane. I never, ever get tired of listening to it. She has been in so many shows, including Priscilla, which inspired her to sing this rearranged version of I Will Survive.
I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. So
Straight after Emma, I stuck around to watch Nick Hayes in his cabaret In Progress. Now, if you saw my interview with Nick, you will know he is hilarious, and his cabaret was so funny. As well as being absolutely beautiful and incredibly talented and can sing impeccably, I just hate him. The whole evening was incredible. He was joined by guests Jess Aubrey and guitarist Craig Watson, as well as singers Julie Jenkins and Sabrina Alawesh. His musical director was Sean Green, who he's about to start work with in Priscilla, Queen of the Desert. Here are a few videos from his cabaret.
And my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching. If I only had a brain.
Wednesday, I was at the cabaret of Genevieve Nicole, my gift to you. I am a little bit obsessed with Genevieve. She is hilarious. If you watched my interview with her, it has had over 150 views. Most of them were me watching it over and over again. I think she's hysterical. She was joined by the incredible musical director, Nick Barstow, who is known for his rearrangements and mashups. And here is one of the songs from her cabaret. They were joined on the bass by Jack Cherry and with special guest Vicky Lee Taylor, who Genevieve originally starred with in a chorus line. Vicky is also hilarious. Somebody needs to give her her own show, just saying. Here are a few songs from Genevieve's night.
You're sitting down wondering what it's all about. You ain't got no money, they will put you out. Why don't you do right like some other men do?
It was time for Velma Celli. Now, Velma is the alter ego of Ian Stroyer, who produced the entire Big Smoke Festival. Ian has worked so hard, and his own cabaret was incredible. Me and My Divas was a collection of songs by the likes of Whitney Houston, Celine Dion, Tina Turner, you name it, they were in there. He was accompanied by Ed Court. And here are a few videos from Hizzy.
Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away.
Sold out. Declan Egan. If you saw my interview with Declan last week, you will know he's a bit of a dish. As well as being ridiculously tall and beautiful, he is so funny. His show was hilarious. Entitled An Evening with Declan Egan, he presented in chronological order songs that have inspired his life, ranging from songs from West Side Story right up until, obviously, Jersey Boys and Book of Mormon, shows which he has starred in around the world. He was joined by his own brother from another mother, Simon Bailey. The pair of them toured with Jersey Boys earlier in the year and obviously have a very close friendship still. And his special guest of the evening was his own sister, Cara, who, with Declan, sang a beautiful version of Shallow and sounded incredible. Returning for the second time this week, Nick Barstow was musical director, which meant another collection of mashups and rearrangements. And if you like the sound of Nick's music, he has got an album coming out later in the year which will feature songs from Noel Sullivan and Alice Fearn, and I will be telling you a lot more about that later in the year. In the meantime, here are a collection of songs from Declan's.
I cry for you. Now cry for me. No, no, I don't love you anymore. Cry for me.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear?
In the bad times, I fear myself. I'm off the deep end. Watch yourself.
Saturday evening, I was at the Magic of Musicals from West End to Bromley. This is a new series of concerts at Bromley's amphitheatre. I didn't even know Bromley had an amphitheatre. It's right next to their Churchill Theatre. And having lived in Catford for a year, I really wish I'd discovered it sooner. They have a whole park and a lake, which is beautiful. Anyway, on Saturday evening, I was at the second of three concerts that they were staging there, hosted by George Tourman, who you might recognise as one of the judges from All Together Now on BBC. He is an incredible host and was so down to earth and funny. His guests were Charlotte Wakefield and Stuart Matthew Price. Charlotte is an old friend, so I went along and sat with her fiancé, Mark. Charlotte gets married next year, so it was great to catch up with her. While Stuart, I've also known for quite a while. He recently had a bit of a break from the industry, so it's really, really nice to see Stuart back performing. His voice is ridiculous. Seriously. And as for Charlotte, not being biased, but she is incredible. So it was a pleasure to hear the pair of them sing an entire range of music. Of course, we had some Mamma Mia thrown in there, but they also finished the concert with a song from Rent. It was all organised by Torch Entertainment, and I'm really going to keep an eye out for them because I really enjoyed this concert. They had a great orchestra and a full choir of brilliant men and women who were superb. I will say one thing about Torch Entertainment. They need to work on their marketing. I live down the road and I would not have known this show was happening had it not been for my friends who were in it. Also, I think they should get a designer in to help with the artwork because these posters really aren't doing them any favours. Here are a few videos from the evening. Home from home this week, the Crazy Cox. And to round off a week of cabarets, I saw the one and only That Steph Parry. Anybody who watches my blog will know that we are good friends. And Steph has recently accepted a job in Mamma Mia The Party, a new immersive experience that comes to the O2 next month. As well as being a regular host at Sing Easy, Steph has done a few cabarets over the past year, and she says that this will be her last cabaret for a while she focuses on her new job. I love Steph, and I love her cabarets, so it was a pleasure to see her one last time. She was joined by her guests, Pamela Blair and Oliver Saville, and Steph mixed it up this time, singing a new song from Mamma Mia The Party, as well as one from Come From Away. It was an incredible evening. Here are some videos from the evening.
Everybody screamed when I kissed the teacher, and I must have thought they dreamed when I kissed the teacher. All my friends at school, they had never seen the teacher blush. He looked like a fool, nearly petrified, cause he was taken by surprise.
The Coast Guard house gets empty. I heard it's all for sale. I took myself out there today, surprised I was, I have to say. For the view it took my breath away.
The super trooper brings a gun by me, but I won't feel blue like I always do.
terrorist action. And the one thing I love more than anything was used as a bomb.
Suddenly I'm in a hotel. Suddenly something has died. Suddenly there's something in between me and the sky.
And that's it for this week. Thank you all for watching. If you would like to subscribe to my YouTube channel, please do, and you will be notified about all the videos that I post on there. And until next week, bye!